Hey everyone, this is Nick. Today I'm going to show you how to make this horizontal bullet chart. A bullet chart is pretty cool data visualization that really packs a lot of information into one small space. So you can see we have kind of this background gauge, this red, yellow, and blue, showing sort of a needs attention area, an acceptable area, and then outstanding area. And then we also have our current value, which is this black line here that will be like our net promoter score or some other survey rating that you might have for your audience. And then it also tells us the goal value. So this is what we want the black line here to reach. You can see right here it hasn't quite reached it yet, but if we change the value over here, let's change this to 85%, that black line goes above the goal and we can know that we're doing pretty well and we're in this outstanding area right here. So when you set up your data source, or actually, first of all, one of the problems with horizontal bullet charts is that they can be kind of tricky to create because you always have to sort of work with the combo chart features, put different data sets on secondary axes. And I wanted to know if there's a way that we could put everything into a single axis, the primary axis on a single chart, and then also maintain the colors of the legend without having to create a custom legend. So this is kind of an interesting technique that combines a couple of different techniques, but everything in this chart is one 2D clustered bar chart. So let's go ahead, make sure that you're setting up your data outstanding, acceptable, needs attention, whatever those values may be, those labels may be. And then we have our goal value, and then we have our current value. This is our net promoter value right here. So in order to create this, we're gonna first highlight everything here. We're gonna go up to the insert tab, insert a 2D horizontal bar chart. And I'm gonna do some tweaks here. Just gonna get rid of the title. We don't need that. I'm gonna make sure that our axis format is to 100%. Now I know that for this example, in terms of net promoter, we actually have a scale of negative 100 to positive 100. So our values in places like museum, zoo, aquarium, when we ask net promoter score of our audience, we hardly ever get negative values. So I'm just maintaining the 0 to 100% here for the time being, but you can adjust your axis as you need to. Okay, so with my chart selected here, you can see that each of those is on its own data series. So each of those has its own bar associated with it. We actually want to cluster all of these together. So what I'm going to do is go up to the switch row column button right here. And now you can see that all of those are on one sort of series here. And then what we're going to end up doing is overlapping all of them. But first I want to go ahead and insert a legend. So I want to keep that legend up there. And this can be the tricky part. Once we do this, so you can see all the different colors are associated with the legend. What we need to do now is let's work on the background gauge colors, the red, yellow, and blue. When you click on a bar and you isolate it, you click double click it to isolate it, you can see that in the source data, it tells me which data, which piece of data this is. So this is the outstanding bucket, goes all the way to 100%. So let's go ahead and recolor this into kind of a light blue shade that I have right here. Let's see. Now you can see that when I did that, it did not update the legend color. So I really want it to. And actually, I think I can just do this manually in the legend. If I highlight this one section right here, I can go up here and then we're gonna go ahead and recolor it to that blue. Already updated. Okay, that's perfect. So that's probably how I'm gonna go ahead and do this. Okay, I'm gonna isolate the acceptable region. We're gonna color that yellow, light yellow. I'm going to go up here to the legend and update that as well. That just automatically updates because that's the color that I just used. I'm going to isolate this one, needs attention, and that's going to be the red. Let's go ahead and do that. I'm going to update it here in my legend as well. Perfect. All right. Now what I need to do, let's go up here to our net promoter value. We're gonna actually make this that black bar, and this is actually gonna be an error bar. So first of all, I wanna actually update the entire bar to this black color that I have here. And you can see that actually updated in my legend, so that was nice here. But what I'm gonna do now is click no fill, and then I'm gonna go up to with that bar selected, I'm gonna go up to the chart design tab, and we're gonna add an error bar here. We're gonna click on percentage. Click on that error bar, go over to that format error bar menu here. We're going to say minus, no cap, at percentage, we'll say 100%. That puts the error bar all the way down to that y-axis line. And then I'm going to update this. Let's say that we're going to put it to 15 points here. And let's make it even darker, this black color. Perfect. All right. Now, for some reason, because we did this, it actually updated my my color up here in the legend, but let's see if we can turn it to black. Okay, perfect. So now it brought the bar back, but what we need to do now is just isolate it. So click it once and then click it again. Make sure to click it twice. And now I'm gonna say no fill, and we'll see if that black stays in the legend. Okay, it does, perfect. All right, now for the goal value, we're going to do something similar. So for this red, we want to change it to blue. I'm going to isolate this by double-clicking it. We're going to go ahead and change it to that dark blue. Nice right here. Now you can see it did not update in my legend, but let's go ahead and manually do that. That works. And now what we need to do is we're going to click on no fill here. Oops, let's see if this will work. Yes, good, it keeps the blue in legend. We're gonna click on no fill. We're gonna do an error bar to this one as well. So let's go to chart elements menu here, error bar, and let's go down to percentage. And I'm gonna click on this. Now instead of 100%, what we're gonna do, I'm gonna say minus, we're gonna say no cap, and I'm gonna say 1%. I'm just gonna put this to 1% here. It's gonna give a tiny little bar right here, and then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go over here to the format menu, and instead of 0.75 points, let's go ahead and make this 30 points, nice and big. I'm gonna type in 30 points, and you can see that it already gives you this sort of like goal, this line here, that's gonna stay there, and we can update this. But actually I wanna highlight the error bar. How you can highlight this error bar, you gotta click on it, but it might be a little tricky. What we can also do is go up to the series option menu here, and this gives you all of the different series you have in your chart. So this is our goal Y error bar. So I'm gonna go down to that and isolate that. Let's go ahead and make this that blue color. Perfect, and it's still in my legend. All right, so now all the components are made, and now all we have to do is click anywhere in on any of the bars, go over to the format data series menu. You can see that the gap width is set to 182, the overlap is set to 0. Let's go ahead and overlap everything to 100%. Now everything goes perfect. Now if we wanted to get rid of these grid lines, we could. We don't really need them. And if we wanted to set the gap width to 0, we could do that. That would fill the entire plot area. And then I can just adjust the dimensions of my chart, the height of my chart. Now you have a beautiful horizontal bullet chart here. And you can update. Let's see, maybe I want the black line to be just a little bit thinner. So I'm going to highlight that black line. And let's just go down to maybe 10 points. Perfect. That looks really nice. And then we don't need the one. That doesn't mean anything for us here. So you have a beautiful bullet chart. You can go ahead and adjust the goal, 75% for the goal. Let's say we wanted to adjust, you could adjust the background gauge. You could adjust the goal. You could adjust the net promoter value right here. Maybe we had a bad month or a really bad month. You can see how those things will change, and just paste this right into your slide or your dashboard, and you are good to go. If you like this video, I hope you will give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button, tap the bell next to it to get notified every time I post a new video in data design, Excel, and PowerPoint tutorials. Remember, you don't need to be a professional designer to look like one using the software you already have access to. I hope you all have a great day, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.